Hi students, today we are going to study a new topic, solubility. First we will discuss about solubility of solids and liquids and then we will discuss solubility of gases in liquids. So first let's understand the meaning of this term solubility. Solubility, it is the maximum amount of solute that can be dissolved in a given amount, or you can say 100 gram of a solvent at specified temperature. Students, it is very necessary to mention the temperature. Okay, so we are saying the maximum amount of solute that can be dissolved in a 100 gram of solvent at a particular temperature, that will be called as its solubility. If you will increase the temperature, the solubility will increase. Now, solubility of solids in liquids. We are going to discuss this topic, how the solids get dissolved into the liquids and what are the various factors which are going to affect it. Cause of solubility. First, we will discuss the point how the solute molecules get dissolved in the liquids. There are four points which we are going to study which are going to affect the solubility. First one, it is interionic interactions in the solute. Students, interionic interactions, suppose if you are talking about NaCl. NaCl, if it has to be dissolved in water, it is called as solute and water will be termed as solvent. Okay, so NaCl, jo hai, they are made up of Na plus and Cl minus ions. So, between these oppositely charged ions, strong electrostatic forces of attraction are present and they are held together by these forces of attraction. And when this NaCl crystal is formed, during that time, the amount of energy released, it is called as lattice enthalpy. So, how can you define this lattice enthalpy, students? The amount of energy released when 1 gram mole of ionic crystal is formed from its constituent ions, that in case of NaCl, it will be Na plus and Cl minus, and they will be held together by electrostatic forces of attraction. So, the ions are held by lattice enthalpy. The first point is interionic interactions in the solute. So, the solute, how much it is soluble in the liquid, it will be depending on the lattice enthalpy. If the strong forces of attraction are present, then it is difficult to break them. And if the ions they are held by weak forces of attraction, then they can easily dissolve. Okay. Second point, intermolecular interactions between the solvent molecules. We are talking about H2O. See students, in this there is a difference in the electronegativity of oxygen and hydrogen. And because of this, the oxygen develops partial negative charge and hydrogen develops partial positive charge. Okay, now because the development of charges, the bond, the molecule, it is polar. And there are two molecules, if you are talking about the two molecules which are having the charges, they will develop a dipole-dipole interaction. This is one of the water molecules, this is another water molecules. They are having a difference of electronegativity and they develop the charges, and that is why they are called as dipole. Okay, what is dipole? The formation of two poles, and they will be having dipole-dipole interactions. Okay, so we are talking about the second point in the solvent molecules. We are having dipole-dipole interactions. Now, the third point is solvation. What do you mean by solvation? Whenever the solute gets dissolved into the solvent, the amount of energy released, it is called as solvation energy. And if you are taking water, then the amount of energy released, it is called as hydration enthalpy or hydration energy. Okay, now students, if the solid molecule has to be dissolved in water, in that case, the hydration enthalpy should be more than lattice enthalpy. Then only the solute can be dissolved easily into the water. Okay, now the last one is temperature. Temperature, we know that if the reaction, that is the dissolution of solid into the liquid, if the process, it is endothermic. Okay, endothermic means the enthalpy, it is positive. That means the reaction proceeds in the forward upward direction by absorption of energy. That means with the increase of temperature. Temperature अगर increase करोगे तो dissolution क्या होगा, ज्यादा होगा, तो हम क्या बोलेंगे, solubility जो है वो increase हो जाएगी. अगर process आपका है exothermic, that means an amount of heat is liberated, तो उस केस में आप क्या करोगे, temperature increase करोगे तो solubility क्या हो जाएगी, हमारी decrease हो जाएगी. So we can say that solubility of a solute depends on the following factors. How it depends? Lattice enthalpy क्या होनी चाहिए, हमारी कम होनी चाहिए for solute to get dissolved. जो solvent molecules है इनके अंदर dipole-dipole interactions जो होते हैं they should be weaker. Solvation energy जो है वो ज्यादा होनी चाहिए, वो हमने यहाँ पे बोल दिया hydration enthalpy should be greater than lattice enthalpy. Okay, और temperature पे कैसे depend करेगी, अगर हमारी reaction जो हमारा process है dissolution का अगर exothermic है तो temperature increase करने पे solubility increase होगी, exothermic है तो temperature increase करने पे solubility decrease होगी. And students, when we are talking about dissolution or solubility of solids in liquids, there is no effect of pressure. वहाँ पे pressure का कोई role नहीं होता है. Okay. Now, one more thing comes. Okay, I'll tell you after this point. Like dissolves like. Okay. हम जैसे होते हैं हमारे friends भी हम वैसे ही बनाते हैं. Okay. Let's understand this in the terms of solubility. Every given solid, every solid cannot dissolve in a given solvent. Okay, अगर हम बात करते हैं NaCl की, if you are talking about NaCl or if you are talking about glucose, they can easily dissolve in water. But if you are talking about naphthalene, if you are talking about naphthalene or anthracene, non-polar solutes. So if you are talking about naphthalene or anthracene, they can easily dissolve in benzene. Okay, so here what we are saying, these are the polar. ये हमारी कैसे solute है? Polar solute है. और water हमारा कैसा solvent है? Polar. कहने का क्या मतलब है? Polar solute will dissolve in polar solvent. Non-polar solute will dissolve in non-polar solvent. That means like dissolves like. Now, why the ionic compounds get easily dissolves in water? There's a reason. Ionic compounds जो होते हैं वो उन्हीं liquids के अंदर, उन्हीं solvents में easily dissolve हो जाते हैं जहाँ पे they are having the high dielectric constant value. Okay? And water की जो dielectric constant की value होती है, it is around 80. For benzene, it is 2.3 something. In class 11th in chemical equilibrium, we had discussed this point. High dielectric constant of water makes it to dissolve ionic compounds in it. But the benzene, it is having a low value of dielectric constant. That's why the polar solutes do not easily dissolve in it. Okay, ionic compounds होते हैं वो इनमें आसानी से dissolve नहीं होते हैं. Now, we will discuss about dynamic equilibrium. If you add solute to the solvent, ठीक है, 100 ग्राम का आपने suppose water, 100 ग्राम water लिया आपने, okay, उसके अंदर you start adding the sugar, जिसको हम बोल रहे हैं solute. So start adding the solute to the solvent. What will happen? This solute will goes into the solution and it will form the solution. And इस process को हम क्या बोलेंगे? Dissolution. The process is called as dissolution. When solute is added to the solvent, it goes into the solution and the process is called as dissolution. Okay, beginning में ये process हो रहा है. After some time, what will happen in the solution? The solid-solute particles, they will collide with the another solid-solute particles and they start coming out of the solution. They start separating out of the solution and this process is called as crystallization. Okay? So, I am writing the name of the process. It is crystallization. So, here the two processes are going on. In the beginning, only dissolution and after some time, the process of crystallization starts taking place. in one time a stage will be reached when the two processes, that is dissolution and crystallization, will take place with the same pace. The rate of dissolution will become equal to rate of crystallization. That means we will say the amount of solute at this stage will become constant. Amount of solute will become constant at this particular stage, and this is called as equilibrium. What we are using the word equilibrium? We will say equilibrium has been reached where the rate of dissolution is equal to rate of crystallization. Jitna solute solution ke andar jayega, utna hi solute solution se bahar aayega. Okay, aur is stage pe jo solute hai, the amount of solute which is present in the solution, it becomes constant, and we will call this maximum amount of solute which is present in the solution as the saturated solution. So I just write down the maximum amount of solute. Maximum amount of solute in given amount of solvent at particular condition or at a given condition. That means वहां पे हमने temperature और pressure क्या कर रखा है, fix value कर रखी है. So उस condition में जितना maximum amount of solute है इस particular condition पे, वो क्या कहलाएगा, उसका solubility. And ये जो solution है वो solution कैसा कहलाएगा हमारा, saturated solution. Saturated solution, it is containing the maximum amount of the solute. अगर आप इसमें solute का amount बढ़ाने की कोशिश करोगे तो what will happen? The process of crystallization will start. So the saturated solution is one which is having the maximum amount of the solute. और unsaturated solution को how we will define, in which the more solute can be dissolved. Okay. अच्छा एक और वर्ड आता है स्टूडेंट, सुपर सैचुरेटेड. व्हाट इज सुपर सैचुरेटेड? इफ यू विल इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर, मोर अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्यूट यू कैन डिसॉल्व इनटू द गिवन अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्वेंट, बट व्हेन इट कूल्स व्हाट विल हैपन, इट विल अगेन कम्स आउट ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन. सो अ डेफिनेट, इट इज फिक्स्ड दैट अ डेफिनेट अमाउंट ऑफ सॉल्यूट कैन बी डिसॉल्व इन अ सॉल्यूशन एट अ पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर एंड प्रेशर. सो वी आर सेइंग दैट सॉल्युबिलिटी, इट इज द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट. Okay, so in this topic we have discussed the solubility of solids in liquids. Next class we will discuss about the solubility of gases.